Hi, everybody. Hello, my partner, Peg Rowe. Good to see you.
Hello. Good to see you, too.
Yes, I'm Beth Ruske. Peg and I are two of the managing partners with Tiara International. We're here today to talk about influence and why influence is important to you and how you lead. One thing before we even talk further is we want to make sure that anyone listening to this understands that we're speaking to you because you are a leader. And leadership is not just a, you know, a title on a business card or a role you play at work. Being a leader is how you lead your life. And that's the context with which we speak about leadership. So when we're talking about it today, we are speaking to you, just to be clear.
Good one.
Yes. So Peg, when we talk about influence, I know we talk about the different kinds of influence.
Right.
So let's just start right there. Like to you, when I say influence, what where does your mind go? The different kinds of influence.
Yeah. So here's the thing I know is that for most people, when we say the word influence, they think that you have to be in an influential position in a company, for example, to yield influence. And our belief is you're having influence all the time, whether you're aware of it or not. So the actions and reactions and behaviors that you show and you demonstrate are going to have an impact on somebody. And that will either give you what we would call reactive influence, where people are just like reacting to you, and that's not always a good thing. You know, maybe if something happens and, you know, it hits you at a cross moment and you say something that is thoughtless that you wouldn't, if you were in your best self, normally say, and yet it still has an impact. You know, people don't just naturally say, oh, well, that's not how she normally is. They're like, wow, what was that all about?
Yeah.
You know, so that's influence, and you're having an impact on someone. When we're talking about influence, we really are talking about it in the framework of being intentional and aware and using that awareness and intentionality to have the kind of impact that you want to have. So really choosing for yourself, how do I want to show up? What's the impact that I want to have? What's the outcome that I'm looking for? And how do I use my strengths and my essence and my best self as a leader to begin to affect that?
Yeah. Yeah, that may sound to some people like, oh my gosh, that's a lot to think about before I open my mouth, right?
Right.
It's actually not. That's just kind of a quick thought process.
Yeah.
That really the tip we would give you here is pause before you speak. Just take a second, catch your breath, and, you know, respond.
Yeah.
Don't react. That's why Peg used the phrase reactive influence. You know, it's a reaction and it causes a reaction.
Right.
So it keeps it in kind of that negative spiral, if you will.
Yep.
The other thing when I was listening to you, Peg, what triggered for me is some people confuse influence with authority.
Yes.
And influence is not necessarily authority. Now, people who have authority might have influence.
Yeah.
But people can have influence without having authority. Right. And that's important to remember because that's the place we all play in. We have the capacity to influence anyone. A smile to somebody at a grocery store. I mean, like simple things, not just big business things.
Right.
You know, like we have that capacity and capability throughout our day.
Yes, we sure do.
Well, but you bring also to mind something about, you know, given today and, you know, we live in this virtual world and a lot of us are having meetings like this virtually as opposed to face to face. It is more difficult than when we're in an office building and we're just, oh, I need to talk to Peg. I'm going to go knock on her door and sit down and we're going to solve something. Right. So what's your sense about this feeling of disconnection and what can we do about that?
Well, I think that comes back again to that sense of intentionality. I mean, when I've worked with clients, for example, who work in large office buildings in downtown Chicago and their companies span more than one floor, and they may have to be in a meeting in one floor and then literally have 5 minutes to get to the meeting on the next floor. We often will talk about how do you use that 5 minutes? You know, how do you finish off in your mind the meeting you were just in? How do you shift gears into what's the impact I want to have in the meeting that's coming up? So that when you walk in the door, you're ready and you're not spending the first 5 minutes of that meeting getting yourself into the meeting. And I think that happens a lot on video conferencing, whether it's Zoom or Teams or webinars, what, you know, whatever the vehicle is, doesn't matter. It's like we tend to go from one to the next, and we barely have mentally finished off with one before we're smack dab in another one. And I think that causes us not to be as aware and intentional of the impact that we want to have.
Yeah. You
know, we're not going to somebody's office, but in a way we are. We're going to another office just by being virtual.
Yeah. You know, it's funny. Where my brain went when I was listening to you is I have these two lovely little nephews who are, you know, 4 years old. And my sister and I were at the table having a conversation, and one of the little ones comes up to the two of us, and he of course just interrupts us. And you know, she says, you know, I'm speaking, wait one moment. He says, I just don't want to wait. And I feel there's so much of that also going on in the space.
Right. Like, yes.
It's just so much to have to wait. Yes. You know, it's like things just don't move as easily, you know, and, and I think we just have to acknowledge that, like, that is the reality of the situation, and it will make it maybe a little bit more challenging in some ways, maybe it's easier in others, but that awareness that, you know, that if you're feeling that way, maybe other people are too.
Well, and the thing is that it's easy to default to sort of going through the motions and not until the end of your day, be aware, like, oh, wow, I had missed opportunities. You know, I could have been more present. I could have been more aware. I could have brought more of myself to just supporting the conversations that we're having. It doesn't mean like, oh, I had to be the center of attention, but it means like, what is it? You can have a lot of influence without opening your mouth, just by the way that you're participating in the meeting, the way that you're paying attention and acknowledging and clearly signaling that you're in the meeting, that you're physically there and mentally there.
Yeah.
And when we don't do that, we sort of like put on an autopilot, and we realize like, oh my gosh, my mind just wandered. It's like, how do we snap back to what's really going on and bring ourselves back to being fully present?
Peg, I think that's a beautiful lead into our third point, which is really about influence. In order to have the influence you want, that intentional or true influence, it does require you to be aware of your presence and how you're coming across. And we're not talking Pollyanna here. We're not always talking about, oh, I need to come across as calm and peaceful and this. No, sometimes being aware how you're coming across as intense and you know, and really, you know, directive. It isn't the how so much as the awareness and the choice you make at that point that you're about to proceed. How do I want to come across?
Right.
You know, and that I think is important as well, that people realize.
Yeah, because that's the thing that we each have control over. There's so much in our lives that we actually don't, you know, like, and we're all seeing that this last, you know, 12 months has been a prime example of, you know, sometimes we have control, sometimes we don't. But we do have control about how we show up. We do have control about the impact that we want to have and the influence that we want to bring in any moment. And that's the piece that we need to step up to, because that is the part that we can control.
Yeah. So we're going to just bottom line this for you now. When we talk about leadership and influence, we want to make sure you understand that everyone has influence.
Yes.
And that we're all leaders in our lives, and how we show up is a choice. We're not victims in the circumstance, even though we might not like the circumstances.
Right.
Yeah. It becomes a choice for us.
Yeah.
There's an intentionality around influence. There's an awareness around how you're coming across. And there's a choice that you make. Mm-hmm. And when you put those things together, it's our belief that you'll have the type of influence that you really truly want to have and intend to have.
Exactly.
Yeah. Thanks, Peg, for joining in the conversation.
Thank you.
Always great. Join us again. Check us out on YouTube. We have many of these conversations posted up there. And join us in our TR Resource Circle, which is open for any woman anywhere in the world. And you can join by going to trresourcecircle.com. Thank you.
Thank you.